Hi everyone, it's Sarah Todd. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking all about the academic accommodations that I have in college. So let's go. The first academic accommodation that I have in college is permission to leave the classroom and, in most recent times, the Zoom classroom for a restroom break. And I have this accommodation because the whole process can just take me a little bit longer and I don't need to be rushed trying to do all of these things. So I need to make sure that I can get down the hall safely, that I'm not trying to rush down the hall because I can't break a fall. And if I fell, that would be really bad because I could get seriously injured. And it also can take me longer to open doors and get the stall door locked and deal with my clothing and wash my hands and all of that. So that's why I have this accommodation. The second accommodation that I have is permission to use my computer for written work. So this can be for homework assignments, quizzes, reviews, exams, essays, really anything written. And this is because I cannot move my left hand. And I can move my right hand, but it's very weak. So I can handwrite things, but my hand just gets tired very quickly. So it can be difficult for me to handwrite all of my assignments and my essays. My hand will get very tired and then I won't be able to finish the work. And if I were trying to handwrite an assignment and I were under a time limit, I would not finish on time and that would hurt my grade. So typing is just so much easier. I also prefer to type my notes in most classes. If it's a class where I don't have to write as much for my notes, I may try to handwrite some of them, but most often I do prefer to type because then my hand doesn't tire out as fast. The third academic accommodation that I have in college is I am allowed to have access to my professor's PowerPoint slides and lecture notes if they're available. So this can be really helpful because even if I'm typing my notes, I may still get behind. I am a very fast typer and people tell me that all the time. They'll say that I type faster with my one finger on my very weak right hand than they do with their two fully functional hands. But my hand still can get tired when I type and I can fall behind sometimes. So it can be nice if I just have access to the PowerPoints and the notes. And that way, if I miss something, I don't have to fret about it. I know that I can just go back and look at the PowerPoint slides and the notes later and catch up then. And that just helps me not fall behind in class if I happen to get tired when I'm trying to type my notes and all of that. So this can be very helpful. The fourth academic accommodation that I have in college is I have permission to record lectures. So I haven't had to use this accommodation yet because my whole first year of college, all of my classes were on Zoom and the lectures were recorded and uploaded in case people couldn't make it to them if they were in a different time zone. Or if they just couldn't attend for any reason, you could go back and watch the lecture later. So I never had to record lectures. I never really felt like I was falling behind when I was taking notes or anything. But if I ever needed to use this accommodation, it would be if I felt like I were falling behind when I were taking notes, because I could just record the lecture and then I wouldn't feel as stressed about trying to keep up while I was taking my notes. Because I would know that I could just go back and listen to the lecture later and catch up then. But yeah, I haven't had to use this yet because my classes were recorded on Zoom, as I said, but I could see this being helpful for me in the future when I do have in-person classes. If I feel like it's a class where I need to take copious notes and I won't be able to keep up, I can see myself using this accommodation frequently. The fifth academic accommodation that I have in college is I'm allowed to have a personal note taker. So this system is actually pretty cool. It's anonymous, so I wouldn't know who my note taker is. And the way this works is a student takes their notes and then they work with the disability office at the school and they send them copies of their notes, and the disability office distributes those copies of the notes to students like me who would need them. This accommodation can be so helpful for reasons like, again, if I felt like I were falling behind in class taking notes, I wouldn't have to feel stressed because I would know someone else was taking notes and I would have those to look at later and make sure that I'm all caught up in the class. So this is really cool and can definitely be a very useful accommodation. The sixth academic accommodation that I have at college is I have time and a half on my quizzes, my essays, my reviews, my exams, things like that. So I have the full time that the other students have plus 50%. So if the whole class had an hour to complete an exam, I would have an hour and a half because 30 minutes is half of an hour. So that's how that works. And I have this accommodation because it can take me longer to write. So if I am choosing to write on the exam, it can take me longer to do that. It can also take me longer to circle my answers. So anything with just writing and doing anything like that can take me longer. And then if I'm typing, that can take me longer too if I start to get tired. And I also am allowed to take breaks. So if I feel like I need to take a break, I don't want to feel like I can't because I'm afraid my time will run out. So having the extra time built in helps me feel like I can feel comfortable taking a break. And these breaks are really helpful because I had spine surgery 5 years ago. And so sitting for extended periods of time is not very comfortable. So that's why I need to be able to take frequent breaks, because if I'm looking down for a long time, my neck gets really sore, and sitting for a long time, my back starts to hurt. So that's why I have the extended time. The last academic accommodation that I have at college is permission to indicate my answers directly on the test instead of using the Scantron sheet or the sheet where you bubble in your answers. And this is because those bubbles on those sheets are very small and they require a lot of fine motor skills to fill in neatly. And those machines where the test sheets are put through, they can be very picky about where your pencil marks are, so it needs to be bubbled in well, and I just don't need the stress of worrying about my hand not bubbling in the answer well enough that the machine can read it clearly. So I just mark my answer on the actual test, and that's a lot easier for me. It doesn't require as much dexterity. I don't have the stress of making sure the answer is bubbled in well enough, and it doesn't take me as much time as bubbling the answer on the answer sheet would. So this accommodation is very helpful. So yeah, those are all of my academic accommodations that I use at college. They are very helpful, and I'm so thankful that I have access to these accommodations. Typically, these accommodations are set up through your school's disability office. So if you need any accommodations, I definitely recommend going to your school's website and checking out their disability office. They usually have so many great resources for you and they can be really helpful. So definitely check out your school's disability office if you need some accommodations. I also want to add that these are just accommodations that I have that I've gotten approved through my school's disability office, and not every school will have all of the same accommodations. Not every school does things the same way. So this is just my experience and these are just the accommodations that I personally have. Also, I do want to let you all know that I have been doing a partnership with Zappos Adaptive for the past few months and it has been amazing. I've been helping them share content about applying to college, getting ready for college, going to college, and all of that, the whole college experience as a disabled person. And that's been on their social media channels. And I definitely recommend that you check it out. I think a lot of the content will be very helpful for a lot of disabled people. So definitely check that out. I will put the links to the Zappos Adaptive social media in the description box below so you can go see my posts and hopefully they will be helpful for you all. But yeah, that's the end of this video. I hope that you found this helpful. Please give this video a like, leave me a comment, hit that subscribe button, and remember to hit that notification bell so you never miss a video of mine. I post new videos every Tuesday at 3 p.m. Eastern and sometimes Fridays at 4 p.m. Eastern, so I hope to see you at the next one. Also, be sure to follow me on social media. The links are in the description box below. And check out my Patreon, and that will be linked in the description as well. Thank you to all of my existing patrons once again. You all are so amazing. And yeah, I hope to see you all at the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!